Hi everyone and welcome back. Today I'm going to share three Christmas cards using the same embossing folder. This is part of a blog hop as we celebrate the new release by Altenew. You will find lovely flower stamps as well as this unique one, which is a stamp set that can help you create lovely mandalas with different elements all around. You'll find bigger and smaller stamp sets, stencils that match the stamp sets as well as dies like always. If you want to see all these products in action, if you want to get inspired and win some prizes, then make sure to visit my blog. You will find there all the info that you need for this blog hop showcasing the latest release. However, in this video I'm going to focus on the embossing folders. They did release a couple of them. This is the Perfect Poinsettia and it features lovely poinsettias. It is really dimensional and it gives you a beautiful design. And the second one is GeoSteps. It is a really versatile one since it gives you a pattern that is very versatile and you can use it throughout the year. Today I'm going to work with a poinsettias embossing folder. I'm going to create three backgrounds so you can see different ways and how you can change the look just by changing the colored cardstock, and then I'm going to turn them all into cards. So here I'm going with a tone-on-tone technique. I'm using my ink pad, which is slightly darker than my red cardstock. And I'm going to apply ink on one side of my embossing folder. If you wonder which one of the sides I'm applying ink, then it is the one that has the label on top. If you notice, it has those black letters on top. Now I'm going to place it on my sandwich and run it through my die cutting machine. I like to do that a couple of times to get a good impression, and you will see that I end up with a lovely design. This would be beautiful even if you didn't do the inking. However, by using a darker ink, you really enhance all those shadows in the nooks and crannies of the design. Now, just by changing the colored cardstock and the ink, you can repeat the exact same process and get completely different results. So here I'm using my white ink and I'm working on craft cardstock. Again, I'm going to repeat the exact same steps. I did add the ink on the front flap, the one that has the black label on top. Again, create my sandwich, run it through my die cutting machine. And here is the lovely result. Very soft and beautiful for holiday cards. In beautiful embossed backgrounds like this one, all you need to do is to just die cut a sentiment and stick it on top. You have a really quick and simple card, but it really makes an impact. Moving on to the third example, this time I'm working on white cardstock and I did prepare the cardstock with my anti-static powder tool just because I'm planning to do some embossing. So here I'm just rubbing my embossing ink all over the front flap again of my embossing folder. I'm going to place my white cardstock inside and then again repeat the same steps, run it through my die cutting machine. And this time I do have embossing ink on the nooks and crannies of the design, which means that when I apply embossing powder on top of it, it's going to stick only there. And check how this really enhances the design just by adding that powder there and sticks in different areas. Now, of course, I am going to bring in my heat gun and melt all that embossing powder and I will end up with a really stunning background. And I'm going to zoom in so you can see all of the backgrounds that I created using the exact same technique, the same embossing folder, just changing the color of the cardstock and the color of the ink that I apply on top. So let's turn these backgrounds into quick and simple cards that you can put together in no time. And I think that if you work assembly line, like cut out many panels, run them through your die cutting machine to emboss them and just stick on top a sentiment, it is going to help you create many cards that will look stunning but in no time. And that's exactly what I'm doing for this card. Now this is a new glue pen, very fine tip for applying glue on very small areas. This is from the latest release by Altenew, and I did cut out the word peace a couple of times. And I'm going to stack one on top of the other to make my sentiment thicker. And I do have the gold one on top. Now the dye that I'm using here is called Fancy Peace Dye. And just like always, you will find linked down below everything I'm using. The card looks stunning as it is. You can stop here if you want, or if you love details like I do, you can add some shine here and there. I am adding with my gold shimmer pen by Nouveau some gold touches at the center of my poinsettias, and hopefully you can see that at the back. And I did finish it off by adding a couple of die-cut leaves from a holly berry. Here are some close-up photos where you can see the dimension that you get with a folder, plus all the extra shadows that you get by inking with a darker shade of ink. Now these backgrounds are really stunning and it is very hard to cover them up with big focal points. However, for my craft background, just because it looks soft, I'm going to fight with myself and cover up a big portion of it. So I am going to create a big focal point with this poinsettia die. I did showcase it in a previous video, so I'm just putting all the leaves one on top of the other together. And if you ask me, this is the perfect focal point for any holiday card. Now all you have to do is to just put it together, super quick and simple, and you can just stick it on top of a pattern paper, for example, or just a simple cardstock. Stick a sentiment and you have a lovely card to go. So anyway, I am going to stick my background on top of my pre-folded card that's 4.25 by 5.5, and if you notice, my panel is slightly smaller than the standard card, so I do end up having a little border, white border all around. Then on top I did add my poinsettia focal point. I did cut out the word wishes, and this is a die from last year I believe, or maybe even older, as well as the sentiment that I'm sticking underneath. Just combine any sentiments that you have to complete your card. Here are some close-up photos and I absolutely love how my poinsettia matches with the design on the embossed background. And now let's move on to the last card for today. For this one, I really don't want to cover up that lovely shine at the background. All I did was to just stick the word holiday, and I'm going to complete it by adding an extra sentiment where I stamped the word happy. And I did cut it out with a banner die so that I can thread it through one of the loops of my word, just to make it look more interesting. And with that stunning background, you don't really need to do a lot on top of it. So here are all the three cards that I made for today using the same technique and the same embossing folder. Don't forget that this is part of a blog hub where you will find lots of inspiration and you will be able to see all the products and new products in action. There are lots of giveaways to be won, so make sure to visit my blog and enter the giveaways. Thank you all so much for joining me today. I hope that you had fun, that you got inspired, and I'll see you all next time.